exception handling. What is the exception handling? Okay, so we have to provide the alternate way to execute your program. Okay, that is called. Just mute in your side. I don't know who is. Okay, just mute in your side, all of you. So, how to handle exception in Selenium? Today topic is that. Okay, so what is exception? I already discussed in your Java session. What is exception? So exception means, I will tell you in the code, right? You are writing some code. I did some typo mistake, right? Then some because of some typo mistake, what happened? Our execution flow of the line is terminated. But I have to execute that line. Then how to do? First we will check where the exception is going to raise, right? Line number. Okay, which type of the exception? So exception means, like I'm going to my office, I'm going to my office and unfortunately my bag, something went wrong, right? But until unless I have to reach my office, so I can go from the alternate ways, right? So might be I can book Ola, or I can go by the auto, or I can go by the public transport, right? So this is the alternate way, alternate flow of the execution, and finally I'm going to reach my office. So while you're developing in your code, some exception raised, then we have to provide two alternate way to execute your code. That is called exception. So I took Ola and public transport or auto. That is how to handle the exception. This thing I took the help to reach my office, means to reach my destination. This is called your exception handling. Okay, so what is exception? So unwanted, unexpected event that disturbs the normal flow of the program is called exception. So slipping exception, file not found exception. You are reading and suddenly you will slip that, right? So you, whatever you are reading, that flow is what? Gone, right? So file not found exception. So like, what do you meaning of file not found exception? I am using one project. That project is not my insister, means it is not in my local. Okay, that project is not there. I want to copy that project from the repository. You know, Git is a tools which is used to, you know, we have a one type of repository, like just it is on the internet, that you think like that. You are downloading something from the internet, right? So that project I'm going to download. That is I kept inside this repository. While downloading your project, one file is missing in your local. But in your local, that file is already there. Why you have kept that file? Because if something went wrong to, you know, while downloading that file, then I will use that local file. So we are providing the alternate way, right, to execute our code. So this is another example of file not found exception. So same thing I have mentioned here. Okay, so how to handle this? Read the file from the remote, you know, local remote, which is in your repository, and catch what we have mentioned, local file, and continue the rest of the program. This read the file locating on git repo. Okay, but what happened? Some file missed. Then in the catch block, we have already used the local file and continue the rest of the program. Okay, so try where we have a possibility to raise the exception, and catch where we are providing the alternate way to execute our program. Okay, so you know how to use the try catch. One more word is there, that is called error. I don't know, you guys already attended exception handling in Java, but I'll show you that one thing. So actually I'll show you the hierarchy of the exception. Actually, exception, what is the exception? So we know the definition and how to handle the exception, you know, the providing the way to handling the exception called exception handling. So now the exception itself is a class. Okay, exception itself is a class. So if you, this is the hierarchy, this is your travel. So travel is your super class. Okay, travel is a super class, and we have a subclasses exception and error. So both are classes, subclass of travel. Okay, so we have know what is the exception and what is the error. Error means we cannot provide the alternate way to handle this. Means error we cannot handle. Got it, right? So your question is, what is the example of an error in your real time when you are developing any code and application? So error means, you know, when in JVM we have a memory location, right? So we have a heap area, okay, a stack area. So when you are, you know, we will go in the JVM, so they have also separated some space to store a static and non-static members, right? So when you are writing non-static, then inside this heap area the memory is allocated for non-static member. So when you are, you know, in I'm using this Eclipse and using the Java. So Java in my system, this is my system, right? This is not a virtual machine, but virtual machine is a, like a, our computer. Got it, right? In the real time we have a virtual machine. I'll tell you the example of error. What do you meaning of error? This is my system. Okay, this system having the Java. So Java is there, then we are able to execute. Java is there in my system, then we are able to execute, you know, Java code. But inside this Java we have a JVM, right? Java virtual machine. Inside this Java virtual machine, inside this JVM is there. So when you are writing the code, so JVM having the JVM architecture means inside this JVM they have memory allocation. This is your stack area, and this is your heap area, and this is your one more is there. Okay, so leave it. So what happened when you are storing non-static value, then here we will get this. But what happened, heap area is full, means heap area having the full, this memory is full. So this thing, we you know, developer and user is not fixing this. So this is called error. Okay, so in the real time we have a virtual machine. In virtual machine we have a Java, because if you are using the Java application, so in the virtual machine we have a your Java install. So in Java what happened, heap area is full, so that is called error. We cannot solve that error, so that they having the different team to deallocate this JVM memory. So this is called error. So someone will ask, what is the difference between the error and exception? Exception we can provide the alternate way to execute our program, but error we cannot handle. So this is the system issue, this is the software issue. So programmer is not handle this. Okay, so this is the most of time error is not caused by the programmer, and these are due to lack of system resources. Error is not recoverable, so out of memory error occurs. Being a programmer we cannot do anything, and program will be terminate abnormally. Admin, one another team is there, that is called admin team, is responsible to increase the heap memory. Okay, now these are the example of, you know, what is the exception and error, but in Selenium, which type of the exception or you will get it. So consider, you know, scenario in which we have to find the element with the help of XPath ID name. In Selenium, not available to find that element, then it will throw no such element exception. I don't know if you guys are doing practice or not. If you are doing the practice, definitely this error came. Definitely. Okay, so it will terminate your program. Actually, we are finding the element, right? Here we are finding the element. If you are take the any website, yeah, this one is the website. So if you are finding any element, might be your XPath is not working or that element is not visible properly, then when we are validating in your script, this element is not able to find, then what happened? It will throw the exception and that code will terminate, right? So that thing I have mentioned. So here one interview question: what is the most challenging thing in the Selenium and what is the challenges you have faced in your project, right? So this is the, also the one most challenging thing to the automation testing or automation tester to handle this exception. Okay, so we can save our program being terminated. So how to solve that program? So here we have multiple way to handle this. So try, I have written this, and catch, I have written this. Okay, so like that we can solve. But what happened? This line will skip, right? So you know one way. So how to use try catch? If you have a possibility, the exception will come, that code will be deployed inside this try. Okay, if exception will raise, then what happened? Catch block will raise this and rest of the code will execute. Okay, interview question: how to handle illegal state exception? If you will go in the Selenium org, so we will go in the Selenium documentation. Okay, Java doc, we will go here, let's type it here, exception. You have a many exception, that package name I do not remember, but or just type here no such element. You can see how many, all are exception, no such element, no such. Yeah, can you tell me why this exception is there? Okay, you can see I told you, right? Exception is a class. So how this exception is going to raise when this might be you are writing any code and this no such element exception raise. Okay, here line of the code, your no such element exception is raised, then what happens? JVM will create object of that exception and will throw on your console. Got it, right? Exception is a class. So how this, you know, JVM is throwing the exception on the console. So what happened? JVM will create a object internally and throw. Okay, so that's why, you know, all this exception are there. So just at least you have to remember 10 exception. Okay, because they will ask in the interview which type of the exception you have faced in your project and how you have handled that no such element. So I have mentioned some important one, so just to read for this documentation you will give the answer for that. Okay, the root cause of java.lang illegal state is we have not to specify the path of driver. Okay, when you are actually I'll show you this illegal state exception is coming that folder. Yeah, so when we'll go in that script, just I'm going for one. Okay, so here. Okay, so just go for anyone, find them. So no such element exception, you know, you did some mistakes here in this line, for your path is incorrect. If we will execute this, then it will throw the exception. What exception will throw? Let's see. Okay, illegal state exception, right? So this is the one exception. The driver executable is not exist, means you have given the wrong path, right? So same thing I have mentioned here. The root cause of this, we have not specified the path of driver. Until you don't specify the correct driver details, then Selenium will throw illegal state exception. Then how to resolve this? Okay, that is the, you have to provide the correct path. Okay. Okay, then so we have another, how to resolve element not visible exception. So these are the exception which is mostly frequently will come. Okay, so that's why I mentioned here. Okay, so this element not visible exception, reason for element not visible exception in Selenium WebDriver duplicates X path. If you are finding the X path, you know, while the finding the X path, where that time, okay, like I have written input, you know, how many inputs are there? 7. When you are finding the X path, if you will use this X path, then what happened? This will come. So why it is coming? While writing the X path, your application might have the taken the X path, the matching more than one element. In this case, Selenium will throw element not visible exception. If you are trying to access some particular element on the web page that is not currently visible, in this case you will get element not visible exception. Try to write, so what is the solution of this two? So first try to write the Unix XPath and use explicit wait. If you are facing this problem, then we will use explicit wait feature of the Selenium and wait for the element is not visible. And once it is visible, you can perform the operation. So like that, how to handle this exception. Okay, so definitely they will ask question. Okay, so we have know at least 5, or you know, you should know the exception. And you will, if you are doing the practice, definitely you are getting the exception. Then definitely if you are doing the practice, if someone will ask the question why this is coming, then you can tell easily. Okay, so practice is very important in Selenium. Element not clickable exception. So it mostly happen in the Chrome. So if you mostly working with the Firefox, then what happen? You will get, even not get this exception. So we will only use Chrome. Chrome does not calculate the exact location of the element, and Chrome always click on the middle of the web element. Sometime you will get the exception due to synchronization issue. Okay, what is the solution of that? Upgrade the Chrome driver in the latest version, get the coordinate to the click link on the button. So we have coordinate, like I have written this code. Okay, so let's see, and try to click on the bicode. So we will use this code for handling this exception. Okay, so we have this same thing, just here what we have used the JavaScript executor, and we have given this XY coordinate and clicking on this. So one more exception is there, how to resolve invalid element state exception. Scenario where you will get this invalid elements state exception, when we try to perform some operation which is not applicable, then it will throw invalid element exception. Actually that page is disabled and you are trying to automate that page, right? So already disabled, then how to automate that, right? So same thing I have written. Let's assume a text box is disabled, then you are trying to perform type of the operation, then it will throw this exception, invalid element state exception. Okay, so if radio button checkbox or any other web page is disabled, if you try to perform click event, then it will throw this exception. Solution for that, always try to perform the required operation based on the element state. If it is clickable, then element, then perform if it is clickable element, then perform click. If it is support type element, then just use send keys. Okay, so this is your, you know, how to do that. So just I commented this point, not required. And one more exception is there, how to handle a still element exception. So a still element exception, how to handle, identify one more time after refresh. If you are getting this, so just I have given this dummy code. Okay, this, so I'm performing this operation and getting this. Then what I did here, I refresh once and again I find this element and just do the operation. So we can handle this a still element exception. So but you will get more solution of that, and whatever the exception I have mentioned, just find the another solution to add in your notes. Okay, so next topic is how to handle calendar or web table. So approach to handle calendar in Selenium. So if you have, then click on this calendar, then get all the TD of the table and using the find element method, using the for loop to get text for the element, and using FLS condition we will get the check the specific date. If the date is matched, then click on then break the loop. So this is, you know, like wait one second, I'll show you that code. Okay, so table, web table, this is the one. One second, I'll show you one more. Hey, steps are same. Okay, we are not doing anything, just you have to, if you have a different application, you have to find the element and just you have to perform. So steps are same in the Selenium, nothing is, you know. So here we are performing this, we will click on that. If you will inspect this element, we can see how to find it is a table. Okay, so you can go through that. You can see we have a implementation of TD, TR something, right? You can see we have a TD, right? TD test data. If you will, just I'm going to, I'll show you this HTML page. If you will go here, you can see we have this TD and TR. So this is your table data. Okay, so how to perform this? What is the scenario? Click on this and you have to select like 28, or you have to select this another date 29. How to perform this and how to handle the dynamic table. Okay, so what you have to do first steps, the testing of that, we have to click on that, then we will validate this, we will store this element inside this list. Why? Because we have to perform the dynamic way. First, what you have to do, you have to, yeah, so this is all the table, complete table. Then what happened, I think I told you, right, regarding crow path. So how to use this crow path, but don't use for your practice purpose if you are working in the real time. Okay, so here you will get it, you know, you can see, got it, right? But don't use crow path. If you are stuck, try to find your XPath. Okay, but if you are completely stuck, not able to, you know, you are stuck, you are doing the practice stuck, then you can take the help of this crow path. But my suggestion is don't use if you are doing the practice, right? So first we will find this element. Okay, so here I already found this element. So first, what first steps, we have to click on this. Okay, right, first steps we have to click on this. Okay, so I click on this, finding this element. So this is your ID, it will click on this. After clicking on this, this table will come, web table. Then you have to extract, we have to select this table, complete table. This it's not coming. Once again, actually this crow path, Okay, so complete table I selected this. After selecting this complete table, so you know, you can write the extract, right? No need to write. This is your table, then attribute name, you have to take this, and this is your, this is a unique one, okay, because this is the dummy site. So this is our XPath, but I'll tell you here one more thing. This is XPath for this, okay, it is selected, but I want to select all this data. Then how to select? TD. Now I have selected all this data, got it, right? So if you can handle any web table, so I have selected this table data, we will store inside this list. But how to find this, you know, we have a more than one element, then we will use find elements. So find elements will return list type, list, right? So it will store inside this list which type? Web element type. Then after that, what we did, we are just going to, here I have used for each loop, okay, then I iterated this. You know, for each loop how it is going to work. It is working like a for loop only, but syntax is different, okay. It is not showing the iteration, but in this example I will show you, okay. So you can use this loop also and this loop also, no problem. And after that, just getting the text, get text, and returning this value. Why we are taking this get text? Get text will return a string type, and here I have put it down condition, this date is equal to, then I click on that, then break the loop and it will come out, right? So this how to handle test data. But the thing is, you have to understand the code, okay? So let's execute this. I have given one assignment, but I already did that, okay? But I'll show you. It will click on date, then that table will come and it will select on 28, right? So this is, you know, how to handle this table. So same thing I have applied with another website that is called Redbus. I did not do anything extra and all. Here, yeah, the challenging thing is changing the XPath. So simply we will validate the XPath and we'll check that. Redbus also we have this table. I don't know which one I took that, but you guys can try in your side. I don't want to send this code, okay? So try, all the steps are same. So here, click on here. After clicking that, again you have to do same steps. We are not doing anything extra here. Same steps we have to perform here. After clicking on that, we have to select this table, okay? This table, complete table. That is the thing. Okay. After clicking that, it's not yeah. It will select, just validate this first. This is, what is the problem? We can go through that. Okay, yeah, it is selected. Okay, so this element, you can see ID is there. It is highlighted, ID is there. Then again you have to same thing, same steps are there, right? You can see that. Then after selecting that, you know, /td, then it will same thing. After clicking on that, same thing I'm going to perform, I have shown you, just you can try to another website, okay? Right, so we have selected this, so it will return what? List of the bev element, and after that we are iterating this, you know, list. I told you, right, same thing, in the last session, what happened, all this bev element will store inside this list. This is your list. So when you are storing, all your date will store here in your list. Okay, it will store inside this list, and list is working on your index. That's it. We are going to iterate this like 31. So we are going to iterate this by using this for loop and get text. Get text means it will return the string type. Why I took this get text? For returning the string type. Inside this string type, in a string class, we have a equal ignore case. If this condition will true, then it will click on that, and just I use the break statement. My system is hanged. Got it, right? Break. Why I use the break statement? Because I don't want to go after 30. I want to click on 30 only, right? So same, we are not doing anything extra here. Just we have, in the last example, we have used for each loop, and here we have used for loop. You can take another example also, handling the web table. You can take another website. Right, so here you can see we have a two table. Okay, so you can use the another table also. Got it, right? So this our test case is passed. So this is your how to handle the test web table. Okay, so these are the basic Selenium we have now, but in the real time we are not using main method. For execution in the real time, we are not using the main method. Anyone can tell me, in real time main method is not executing, then how to execute your test cases in the real time? Anyone having the idea? If you know the Selenium before you have learned and you are repeating my session. Okay, in real time we are not using main method, then what you are using? So in real time we cannot perform the operation with the main method. So how to perform the operation? So we have a beautiful framework that is called TestNG. Okay, so in TestNG we have a many features. So what are the features is there inside this TestNG? Okay, so what happened? Like, if you are using here, if you have a multiple test cases, then we cannot create multiple classes, right? Okay, we have this, all are the test cases, right? So I have created, you know, how many classes. If you have a 1000 test cases, then how to execute 1000 classes we can execute? No. So we have one framework that is called TestNG. So go through this, the people who have developed this TestNG. Just I will give you the introduction of TestNG today. So TestNG is a framework. Okay, so what is this TestNG framework? Inspired from JUnit and NUnit, but introduced in the some new functionality that make more powerful or easier. Okay, we have, so I'll come that. So NG means next generation unit testing framework tool. So we have a some unit testing framework tool that is called NUnit. It supports Java, JUnit support Java, NUnit support .NET, TestNG support .NET and Java both. And most popular too, R, file something that support Ruby and PyDev support Python. Okay. So all these unit testing framework tools acts as a plugin for the Eclipse. Okay. So tomorrow I will explain. Okay. Test engine. So I'm going to stop your session. Thank you. Good night. I'll send you the notes, guys. I'll send you the notes tomorrow. Don't miss the classes. Tomorrow session is your, you know, framework component. So that is the part of